because of the outstanding productivity in the last part, which included beating a boss, a semi-boss, also known as a mini-boss. I don't care. Demi-boss, bi-boss, I don't freaking care what you call it. Also, a new visor, and bridging the two areas that couldn't become one in the Sanctuary Fortress, I've decided to do a couple obligatory pickups because they are no longer out of the way. So yeah. Ahem. That is the first thing. The second thing. The missile expansion, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, did I mention the spinner? Now why would there be a power bomb in a boss area, namely Spider Guardian area, unless it carried something good? Such as a portal. But not any kind of portal, it's a super duper portal! It'll send you back in time! Oh well. Actually, it just sends you to the Dark World, like always, and because we mentioned the Key Bearer lore that related to this area, I guess you can add two and two together. Yep. So what we got here is your run-of-the-mill boost ball spider track puzzle. And this led to nothing. But of course, it can't lead to nothing. It led to a Sky Temple key. Since it was so far out of the way, I felt like I had to get it now. Lest I either A, forget, or B, just decide to collect them all at once. In which case, that would increase the amount of editing I would do exponentially. What? Oh, back up here. What? I'm out. Did I not? What the fuck? Did I? Oh my god, you fucking moron! When you have an amazingly productive part, you can be guaranteed the next part is going to be shit. Hey everybody, it's 40Warrior, welcome back to Metroid Prime 2 Echoes. I wasn't referring to anything that was going to happen in this part. What happened was I had to reset the game once, and I didn't save, so I had to do the Caretaker class drone again, and everything that came with it. It was not fun, and it was very angry. A lot of anger was put through this gamer's mind. I have a lot of anger too with this guy. He needs to shut the fuck up and leave me the freak alone. Are you fucking kidding me, game? No? You can't affect me when I'm down! As I was saying, hit the res bit! And stop fucking falling, jeez. It's gonna be one of these parts, isn't it? Anyway, here's the Twilight. And no, I'm not talking about those vampire movies. Fuck them. There, all but Umos, the last sentinel of Aether, entered life preserving stasis. And that's basically where we are now. At the Twilight. Of the Great War. And the great poison!
Okay, maybe not the great poison. But wishful thinking, right?
Who would wish for a great poison anyway? Certainly me, evidently. Anyway, there's a bunch of spider ball track stuff going on here, so... I'd be remiss if I didn't make a mention of that. Or, well... to that end, do something about it. And here we have these moving things. You need to use the red sticks as your guide. Because you go too far, you're going to get bumped off. You don't want that. Now, there are two things you can do here. One, you already saw, is this bomb slot. And one is to continue onward. So, we will be going to the dark world, because over there is going to be a dark temple key, and we want that, for obvious reasons. Although, it always escapes me as to how I get it, because I know I have to do like 5 different things, including get a new movement system, just to get the thing. And that can get kind of long and tedious, and leave me with a bunch of, okay, now what do I do moments. The worst type of moments, for sure. Good thing my hand-eye coordination's decent. Now I'm going to fuck up. Maybe I should call my fuck-upperies more often. Because... well, if you can jinx it, then, I mean... surely jinx go the opposite way, too, right? Of course they do. And don't call me Shirley. Let's... oh man, which way do I go? Not going that way. Going this way. You knew there had to be something really good here. Just had to if they put you through that crap. Needless to say. Lots of joy. Lots of joy. Now. To that end... going through there is really pointless at this point, that room right there, so no real reason to go through it. At least none that I can foresee at this given time. Unless, of course, you like fighting quad mates. In which case, be my freaking guest. Also, be my guest, you want to make this jump. I guarantee you can't. Not unless you're like a god. Back we go. Back into Resbit land. Actually, back into the dark world. Now that we've bridged everything, we can actually bridge our way over to a part of the Dynamo Works I couldn't get to before because of a sonic door. So. Oh yeah, did I mention these guys are also here? And evidently, that guy was playing Trick or Treat with me. By which I mean, he was tricking me into thinking that he was frozen. But clearly, he wasn't. Now that shenanigans out of the way. A few places we can go here. And I mean, I really want to expose as much of this as I can. And the aerial training site, and you see there, I can't go that way. I need a certain beam that I do not possess, so maybe there isn't much bridging going on in the dark world. That didn't happen. Moreover, I think the game's trying to be a total jackass. But... please tell me those are not. Okay, good. Dark creeds are one thing. Dark Metroids. Yeah, I gotta go through that bullshit, and with preeds, yeah, they're not always the nicest things. Thankfully, they're not infinite. At least I don't think so. Now, as I was saying,
It's another one of those portal hopping games, I guess you could say. So, let's portal hop away.
Portal hopping games can be kind of tedious at times, I guess. You know what else is tedious?
When your server goes down at work and you basically can't do shit for over an hour. That's exactly what happened today. It was not very pleasant, as you'd imagine. Of course, the last time it was like my, our internet was down for like 3 days and... Oh man, that was 3 days of suffering right there. Because, well, during lunch, what do you think I do? Surf the web. If I could play video games, my god, I would, but no way. You know that ain't gonna happen, and you know that it's blocked off. Can't do shit about it. Or can we? Well, evidently. We can do shit about it, but unfortunately for us, certain things aren't going our way. So, what we need to do is find a way to move. I can't make that jump, obviously, so that's immediately out. But there's this. As you see right here, this is like a certain type of vault. So, obviously, tough to open. Now, what does seem to irk me is the fact that I should have a way to go across there, and, well, that's because I'm completely blind, evidently. I did say this was not going to be a very productive part, right? It might be productive, it might not be. Either way, I'm going to be lumbering around quite a bit. It's the theory of conservation of greatness. You do something great, it has to be canceled out. And yes, those are dark war wasps. I'm not sure if I scanned them yet. If not, I probably should. I mean, what else do you need to know about them? War wasps are so irrelevant now that the fact that they even introduced a darkling type of this now is also irrelevant. Basically, completely irrelevant. They're just there to serve more as a distraction than anything, kind of like the preens, I guess, from before. Now that we're outside and we actually have ways to navigate, get your freaking thing ready. That dark beam is going to be your life, your savior, and, well, your protector. As I said. Now that you have a way around, you can do things. And you have just enough space to strafe, so I guess that is something as well. Hopefully I make these dark beams count, because I really, really don't want to resort to other tactics, because you've seen what other tactics can do with a resbit. Not much. Not much. They are very, very tisk-tisk when it comes to the resbit game. And you can tell where the resbits are going to be, because those little balls there that you see on some of those platforms are kind of a dead giveaway, actually. Now, if you ask if this helps you in any way, I hit you! Or did I not shoot? If I didn't shoot... And sometimes... You know, Eric, you can bitch all you want about how the Echo Trilogy is made easier and shit like that. Well, guess what? Sometimes I wish I didn't have these pointing shoot controls. They can make everything that's not point-blank shot an adventure. Well, anyway... All I have to do is just go back to the thing, so I'll meet you back there. It won't take long. So, when we opened open up the vault. What we get? If you can't tell what that looks like, I'm gonna murder somebody. I'm gonna murder somebody. I swear to God, the game has it out for me tonight. Huh. I think I was too busy with the respite to worry about that. I guess it happens. At least the respites aren't around. I'm not sure what took longer. The task itself, or having to see the cutscene of going back and forth, 20,000 times! Oh, I'm in a good mood. I love it. I love being in a very good mood. Anyway, here's a screw attack. This motherfucker kills everything. That is unfortunate to get its wrath. It's basically your triple jump, your quadruple jump, your quintuple jump, your sextuple jump, and your heptuple jump. Yeah, you get extra jumps with a screw attack, kind of like in the first Prime. And if anything crosses its path, it's not going to live. So, it's kind of good in that regard. It's a don't really fuck with a weapon. So if there's a troublesome respite around, I mean, by all means, kill it. Kill it with fire. I won't stop you. I'll be doing me a favor. And just remember, you do have a bit of a knockback if you hit a wall. Sometimes a knockback will knock you off. Oh. Dark Pirate Air Troopers. Yes. But that's not the real reason we're here. The real reason we're here is... well, what is it? This is where things get really hazy for me, because I just don't remember.